And especially with the whole Twitter craze now, Facebook started adding all these applications, all these status updates. So when I log on to Facebook, all I would see is, my friends or my Facebook friends, not actual friends, saying, "Oh, I did this today. I felt this way today. I think about this," and five sodas that I like. It was just like status update crazy. Like it was Twitter, but now it's not anonymous. I know these people, or I know of these people because they went to my high school or stuff like that. And it just felt pointless. It was a waste of time for me. I wanted to use Facebook as a tool, not really, this ridiculousness. And no one cares about you. No one cares about them. It's just a way to spend your time away on browsing photos or playing Facebook games. What is the point of a social networking tool if you're not actually socially networking? That's why I grew out of Facebook and I kind of got out of that. And it's just really weird, and it becomes an advertising avenue too when you have all these Facebook groups that you can be fans of, like the Facebook group for companies, Facebook groups for organizations, which I think is pretty cool, like nonprofit organizations being a Facebook group that you can be a fan of. It's really interesting and all, but it just wasn't for me. And then I ended up moving to Twitter, which is a whole another thing because now I had a game trailers blog site, YouTube channel, and I was contributing all these things onto the internet. And Twitter for me was, I guess, in a simpler, to put it in a simple way, it was like my way of, it was my ad space. I advertise what I contributed, and people can come to it and view it. That was kind of how I used it. Although I really liked being able to see the updates of, various companies, anonymous people, and various, industry insiders in terms of gaming, in terms of news and stuff like that. But it just really felt, I think I got disillusioned with it because it felt like an ad space for everyone else. Of course, I wasn't expecting any communication, but for that entire space to feel like I'm just looking at ads, it just, that's what it felt like. I log in and all I see are ads, go click on here, come click to this site. And I found a lot of really cool websites and a lot of cool, interesting stuff through this way. And I was following a lot of news sites, news places too. So whenever there's an important event coming up, I could just go into Twitter and I find out what's going on around the world and around the news industry. That was really cool. I think out of all the social networking I've done, Twitter was probably the most useful tool I've ever used. But eventually, it was just like, wait a minute, this is making me really lazy in a way because if I just bookmark the websites and I go there myself directly, I don't even have to go on the Twitter. I could find out the, I go to NewYorkTimes.com. I know what's going on. I go to, it was, in a way, Twitter has become kind of a commercialized thing. Where, oh my God, contest this, contest that, follow me this, get more followers, and a lot of people are doing that thing where they follow and they do like subliminal or sponsoring other companies, so they get money for people who follow them. So the more followers they have, the more money they get. So it becomes like a business type of deal. And I wasn't wanting to be involved with that. When I contribute on the internet, I contribute because I like to do it, not to make money, which I know I won't make many because I'm not gonna ever have a good amount of followers. I know my limits with that. So it just became really weird. So I don't know. For me, the best thing is just being able to communicate with people, and all these social networking sites, they don't really allow for that. Me, the simple thing is, like a chat system, MSN, or I use Skype now. Skype is good. And email. Like, someone's email address, you know the person, you want to just, you don't want to actually call them up and feel awkward. You send them an email, it's like a letter, but you don't really have to know the person either personally. And there's so much that can be said. And email is personal, is closer, and you communicate. Where has the communication gone out of the social networking stuff? That's what I want to know. Where's the discussion? Where's the personal connection? And I never felt anything like that with like Twitter, Facebook, friend feed, any of that. So that's why I kind of quit with that, and I'm sticking with, just regular stuff. I'm the typical type of person that actually likes talking on the phone and rather than texting. You know, this whole culture of texting, status updates, and profile browsing and photo browsing, I don't really understand, but that's why I just stick to just regular phones and emails and blog sites. Maybe it's just me.